It's time for the match game. Hollywood Squares. Our whiz from Aftermath, Jamie Farr. From Hotel, Heidi Bohay. From another world, Linda Dano. McLean, Stevenson. Arsenio Hall. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares, are Gene Rayburn and John Bauman.
Yeah. Gene Rayburn pressed your wedding on your jacket.
Oh, yes, yes.
Was that something you spilled?
Just a club. Listen, does it appear to you that Arsenio is wearing glitter in his hair? I thought it was an optical illusion.
We dressed alike, yes. And I couldn't find one of these hats, so I figured I'd spray some of that stuff in there. And
it really is, isn't it?
And the last white man to touch my hair, I shot him, so be cool.
Oh, all right. Okay, I quit. I give up.
You know what they look like?
What?
Losers on Dance Fever.
Take a bath. Okay, shall we begin? All right. Now, let's say hello to our two players here, Joe Credit and Chris Vork. Welcome. Nice to have you with us. Going to find out about Joe first. Tell us about you, sir.
I live out in Simi Valley. I've been here for 4 years. Before that, I was from Boston. And
great place.
Oh, yeah, wonderful. And if you make a joke about my name, I promise to laugh.
Joe Credit? Well, now, wait a minute. You want me to make a joke about your name? Well, I studiously avoid that sort of thing. When, you know, because of the first lesson you have to learn in show business is never do or say the obvious. Anyone want to make a joke about Joe Credit's name?
No. Joe Mama. Joe Mama.
Joe Mama?
Joe Mama.
I don't know what that means.
Credit. I don't understand.
I can't even understand what you're saying.
Joe Mama.
Joe Mama.
All right.
Instead of Y-O-U-R, I put J-O-E there, and I said Joe Mama.
Okay, I got gotcha.
You could say...
When your jokes need to be explained, you're in trouble, Arsenio.
You could say that she works to get credit, couldn't you?
Chris, I suppose Voigt. So.
I didn't say it.
Joe,
I said
you want to play this game?
I sure do. So I'm really happy to be with you.
Okay, nice to have you with us.
That's it.
Now we're going to hear from Chris. Okay, Chris, that's enough.
Vork.
I live in Kokalala, Idaho.
Kokalala?
Uh-huh. That's south of Sandpoint and north of Athol.
There is one in Massachusetts also.
Athol, A-T-H-O-L.
A-T-H-O-L, that's right.
Yes.
And you live out here now?
No, I'm visiting my parents who live in California. I have two small daughters, Quinn and Gavin, that keep me very busy. I love snow skiing and beaching in California in the summer.
Well, you look like you've got a great tan, Chris.
Thank you.
And now, we'll play the match game, if it's all right with you. I mean, we don't have to if you don't want to.
With us.
All right. We'll play three rounds. The winner will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Cool it. Here we go. Joe won the toss. You go first.
I think I'll go with B.
All right. Quiet.
Yes, Scrap.
I'm sorry.
Okay. I'm going to get the whip out again.
Okay.
Throw the whip out.
Okay.
Joe. Here
we'll
it is.
Good. Okay. Yeah.
The sign maker said,
yeah.
Weird Willie just had me paint an all-you-can-eat sign for his business. The strange part is, Willie owns a blank store.
Wait a minute, Willie. The sign maker said, Weird Willie just
had me paint an all-you-can-eat sign for his business. The strange part is, Willie owns a blank store. What kind of business did Willie own is the question.
Yeah.
Let me just see. Okay.
Who won the toss? I was attending attention.
He won the toss.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just listening.
Joe.
To where she was originally near.
Giuseppe. Upper chair's ready. Ready for you, Linda?
Yes.
Here we go, Joe. The sign maker said Weird Willie just had me paint an all-you-can-eat sign for his business. The strange part is, Willie owns a blank store.
A shoe store.
Shoe store, anything that's not edible. It's okay. Anything not edible here is wide open, anything.
Yeah, well, I got to it before they became shoes. I said pet shop.
A pet shop. That would be crazy. What do you say?
I said a tire shop.
A tire shop. That's goofy. That's good. Anything goofy like that is great.
Well, mine's not goofy. Mine, I said a clothing store.
A clothing store. You got. Now, why would you boo that and not boo the tire shop?
Really? Come on.
She's better looking than the other two people.
Yeah, but they booed me.
Oh, wait a minute.
They booed her. What do you got?
I know. Right? They're a twisted audience. They agree. Well, oh, what do I have? I have a furniture store. Thank you.
Wait a minute.
Well, that shoots my theory to pieces.
Tire store. Linda?
You could start to boo now. It's an appliance store.
Appliance store.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
I'm sorry, Joe.
Arsenio.
Being the McLean Stevenson of the ghetto, I said tire store.
All right. That was yours, Joe. Now let's see what we have for Chris.
Oh.
Texan. I don't think this is a real cowboy bar. Instead of a mechanical bucking bull, they have a mechanical bucking blank. This ain't no real bar. That ain't no mechanical bucking bull.
This isn't even funny.
That's what's so funny.
That's not why we hired you, Jamie.
Nobody ever does.
All right. Ready, Chris?
Yes.
Okay, Jamie, here we go. Tex said, I don't think there's a real cowboy bar. Instead of a mechanical bucking bull, they have a mechanical bucking blank.
Pig?
Pig. All right, any animal. Pig, sheep, dog, whatever.
Any animal?
Well, sure. Instead of a bull, they would have
something
else.
Well, I know,
else.
But that's
she came
not
up with a pretty good
funny
response.
Well, I like her response. I'm not crazy about mine. I said cowgirl.
All right, that's okay. Better
cowgirl.
Than okay.
They don't want to know where the bar is, Jamie.
I put bartender.
That's okay.
I thought you said any animal.
Well,
you didn't boo McLean, so you can't boo me. I said bartender.
She's looking for a mechanical bucket.
Well, you didn't boo McLean and Heidi, so you can't boo me. I said calf.
Calf is okay.
I couldn't get away with it.
I don't think it's
a good try, though.
No, that's
good.
A bull can. You should be.
I said waitress.
Nobody. Waitress. All right. Here's the last chance for a pig.
I think.
You aren't going to get it.
Come on. I'm already scared of this crowd. But this is like the Manson family, guys in beards.
Boo!
I said pink Volkswagen.
You get
it.
Crazy. So there it is. 0-0. That's round one, but that's a tough round. You'll get to the easy one right after this for you. Here we go with round two.
We now, are.
The score is tied, and he went first last time. Chris will ask you to go first this time.
I'll take A, please.
All right. You've got it. Anything you say is okay with me, Chris. Here we go.
Work.
The doctor said to Sydney, the sword swallower, Sydney, I'm putting you on a strict diet. From now on, you can only swallow blanks.
Swallow blanks. Okay.
All right.
I'm back at school.
They're both good, really. Yeah.
Uncle Jeeves, he's looking at my paper.
All right, here we go, Chris. The doctor said to Sydney, the sword swallower, I'm putting you on a strict diet. From now on, you can only swallow blanks.
Pocket knives?
Knives. All right. Knives. What did he say?
Knives.
You said knives.
You're an actor.
Yes,
sometimes. Could have fooled me.
Yeah. A lot of people might think there's a difference between a Perry and a pocket knife. But right. I know plenty of guys that'll put a Perry knife in their pocket when they don't have a pocket knife. Okay?
Okay.
I said Perry knife.
Perry knife. Okay. What do you say?
I said knife.
All right. You had two good answers there.
I sure did. And did you see which one I threw out?
No.
I threw out the one that she said. And I chose needle.
Well, that's
instead.
A good one, too.
Yeah. She was a real strict. Now, wait a second. Now, just one gosh darn minute. Just one gosh darn minute, or I'm on my way back Athol. Because you cannot boo a good answer simply because it didn't match.
Yes.
Correct.
Right.
I guess you can, huh?
I continue.
Try,
Linda.
That's why they put him
well,
on the spot.
Well,
Bang, 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 no, no,
blur. Keep going.
Razor blade.
Can I put it down?
Yeah, finish with that. Razor blades is hers. What's
yours? I said exactly what she said. Pocket knife.
Okay.
For round two.
Yeah. All right, Joe, this one's yours. Newlywed Nan said to her mother, this is a long question, so
yeah,
listen.
Do the mother. Go ahead. Oh, no, do newlywed Nan.
Newlywed Nan.
Yeah, go ahead. Go on and see this.
Who asked you, Jamie?
Come
on.
No.
This is great. Come on.
No,
oh, come on, Gene.
No,
do
I'm not
going to
do it. No.
Do the mother. Do somebody.
I've never done Nan before. But I'll try if you want me to. This is the way Nan talks. She says, Mom, being married to a research scientist is awful. On our wedding night, he wouldn't come to bed until I dressed up as a blank. Nan is speaking.
Yeah. Yeah. Nan said to her mother, Mom, being
married to a research scientist is awful. On our wedding night, he wouldn't come to bed until I dressed up as a blank. Newlywed Nan is speaking.
Right.
Research scientists are the operative words. You need some help, a little clarification?
Yeah.
Good. All right. Yeah, those are two good possibilities. The upper tier is ready, so is the lower tier. So, Joe, we come to you. Newlywed Nan said to her mother, she says, Mom, being married to a research scientist is awful. On our wedding night, he wouldn't come to bed until I dressed up as a blank.
Guinea pig.
Guinea pig is a good one. Hey, very good. Guinea pig is a traditional...
That's an excellent answer. It's much better than the one I came up with.
What did you come up with?
Test tube.
Test tube. That's good. Test tube and guinea pig are both excellent.
I'll tell you what I put down, Gene.
What'd you put down?
I put down a bunny rabbit.
A bunny rabbit. They use those for research also.
That's right.
That's okay. Leave him alone. He's wearing a blue blazer.
Okay.
Can't be all bad.
Boo. I said rat.
A rat. Rats, guinea pigs, they're all used in laboratories. What have you got?
Got a rat down here.
Yes. They didn't do that. He's doing things behind your back.
My brother-in knows. Talked them into it.
Right. All right, Linda, you're up.
Well, they use monkeys.
They do.
They do.
Yep. Some research. Come on, one guinea pig, Arsenio.
At first, I wrote Athol, but dressed like an Athol. But then I put white rat.
White rat.
Wrong.
All right.
So there we are at the end of round two, 4-0 to score. Chris is ahead. Third and final round coming up right after this. Here we go with the third and final round. Chris, you're ahead. You'll go first.
A, please, Jim.
A it is. Now, two people play. John and Linda, please respond to this.
Ooh.
With this question.
I guess it's
you. Just the two of you. Oh. She's matched everyone else. Have you heard of the two jerks from Italy, the world's worst Italian restaurant? Have you heard about that place?
No, but they probably didn't match in the last round either.
Here's what happens there. If you order garlic bread, the waiter brings you a slice of Wonder Bread and blanks on it. That's it. Excellent.
That's it. Oh, I didn't see that.
Ready, Linda. Here we go. The two jerks from Italy, the world's worst Italian restaurant. If you order garlic bread, the waiter brings you a slice of Wonder Bread and blanks on it.
Bits.
She said spits. What do you say?
I said breathe.
Breathe. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, no, 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 no.
Breathe.
It's his fault. I cheated.
No, that's it.
All right. So, Chris, you remain at 4, and that means, Joe, you can tie it with 4. However, you can win it with 5. Here it is. The referee said to Bob the Boxer, I don't care if it is your good luck charm. You cannot box with a blank in your glove. Want to read it again?
I'm ready, Uncle Gene.
Very good, Arsenio. You may go to the head of the class. Wash the glitter out of your hair first, though. Ready, Heidi?
Yes, I'm coming.
Now, Joe, the referee said to Bob the Boxer, I don't care if it is your good luck charm, you can't box with a blank in your glove.
Horseshoe.
Very good, Joe. Oh, Joe's a good player, isn't he?
This I crossed out, but I thought this would be a good answer. Sugar Ray Leonard in the boxing glove. I did say horseshoe.
You did say that. All right, one for Joe. 4-1 to score.
I said prunes. I said horseshoe.
You said horseshoe. 4-2 to score. Hello, darling.
Hi there. I said horseshoe.
4-3 to score. One more horseshoe ties the score.
Bob, 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 dang, 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 dang. Horseshoe. For you.
One more horseshoe wins the game, and there it is. Right there. Chris, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
We're going to send some gifts to you for the match game. Chris Quark, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, how do you feel?
Great.
Good for you. Now we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares. Here comes the rest of the set. 3 more stars will come in. John and I will trade places. Got a lot of excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Hamilton's Millennium 4 Ladies Quartz Watch, Micron plated case and bracelet, adjustable hook lock, furnished by Hamilton. And some of our departing contestants will receive Jonathan Martin dresses and sportswear, now in silks, linens, and other naturals for that custom-tailored look. No one dresses a woman like Jonathan Martin. Qualifil, the luxury pillow, is non-allergenic, scrunchable, plumbable, washable Qualifil, a modern alternative to down. Mr. Turkey brand, Turkey Frank, lunch and meats and sausage, the great tasting way to cut down on fats and calories. Ideal for lunch or dinner. Real chocolate and 100% vegetable shortening make it easy to taste the sunshine difference in Hydrox chocolate and cream. Sandwich cookies from Sunshine. Pour yourself a frosty one. Rich, creamy A&W root beer or one calorie sugar-free A&W. And now, it's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Square. Our win from Night Court. Paula Kelly. From Scrabble. Chuck Woolery.
Texas. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
Oh, Arlene, you're just too dignified for this. What are we going to do? We'll be back in a minute to play Hollywood Square.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
And here he is, Joe Credit, who's the guy who says he saw me with Sha-La-La at Suffolk Downs in about 1973 or something. Aerosmith was the opening act, right?
That's right.
I remember it well. People threw beer cans at me all night. We're not going to make any jokes about your name, Joe Credit, but you're an okay guy and you made your way through Match Game. Good for you. You're going out to Hollywood Squares. No, come back here, Joe. Stay here for a second. We have three new celebrities to introduce. They are Paula Kelly, Arlene Francis, and Chuck Woolery. And for today, I have something to bring up about Paula Kelly. You are certainly the first person who has ever been a guest on our show who has a dance scholarship in your name at a wonderful university. What about it?
Oh, yeah. Well, am I the first? Well, I'm ecstatic. UCLA is going to be offering a dance scholarship in my name this fall, Paula Kelly Dance Scholarship. So all you graduates, come out there and do a couple of twirls. Help you get through school.
Well, congratulations to you, Gene. And I certainly don't have dance scholarships in our name. You probably don't either, Joe. But why don't you and I dance over here and play Hollywood Squares? Here we go. Here is our defending champion. She is Nancy Lazarus. How many days for you, Nance?
It's my third day.
I think it is. $22,350 so far. A wealthy lady. All right, I'll put you on the spot. What are you going to do with $22,350?
I desperately need a new car. So that's what I think I'm going to do.
Okay, well, depending on the car, there may be a lot of that money left over. And depending on what happens to you today and possibly in a subsequent day, you may win even more money. But Joe Credit is going to have plenty to say about that. We're going to play Hollywood Squares until we all hear the time's up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point goes on to play Supermatch, which is worth up to $30,000. Don't ever change, Joe. The first game is worth $100, $25 for every square. As always, Nancy, it is your turn to start. Pick a star and let's go.
McLean, please.
McLean Stevenson. You and your wife are getting divorced.
So?
Okay, he doesn't care. Can we throw out this question? You and your wife are, pretend you and your wife are getting divorced. Yeah. According to the American Veterinary Association, who will suffer the most by this split? Your dog or your cat?
Yeah, heavy. Taken from the book of dumb. Well, from the movie, who cares? I would say the dog, because cats are D-U-M-B. I love cats, but they're not...
All right, great. Now we're going to get a bunch of letters from cats.
I hate cats.
Thanks, McLean. Nancy, he says your dog will suffer more from the divorce. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
Your dog will suffer from the divorce. But I think, you get the square very well done, but I don't think it's because cats are D-U-M-B. I think it's because they're I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T.
Where does that spell?
Joe, pick a star.
Arsenio.
Okay, Mr. Hall.
Here we go.
It was recently announced that Pia Zadora is going to have one. Is it a baby or a one-woman show on Broadway?
I'll tell you, if she has that show, I'll be there opening night. Because she's a very talented lady.
I'm sure.
I didn't mean, Pia, I didn't mean that, babe. I don't want to find a horse's head and some Dubonnet in my bed tonight, you know? Okay. Okay. I think it's...
Don't look up there. Yeah.
Are you following this, Joe? You're going to have to answer this question in a second.
I think it's
yes, give me an answer.
The one-woman show on Broadway. That's what I heard when I was in Vegas last week.
Pia's, okay, you know who Pia Zadora is. He says she's going to have a one-woman show on Broadway. Agree or disagree, Joe?
I'll agree.
Pia Zadora is going to have a baby. No, you should have disagreed with Arsenio. And your opponent gets that square. So that's two X's right up there in a row for you, Nancy. Pick a star.
Paula to win.
This will give you the first game. Are there more bones in a woman's body than there are in a man's? Or don't bones have anything to do with gender?
Well, now. Think about anatomy here. It is. Actually, I think there are more bones in a man's body simply because of the addition of...
That's not one of the possibilities. Oddly enough, that's not one of the possibilities. There either are more bones in a woman's body or... Bones have nothing to do with gender.
Oh, okay. Bones have nothing to do with gender.
Okay, what do you say, Nancy? Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
Men and women have, in fact, the same number of bones. Yes, then bones have nothing to do with gender. You get the square. You win the first game. Because in a man's body or a woman's body, there are 206, count them, 206 bones. You can count them over the next couple of minutes and then come back with us for the $200 game. See ya.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
I'm Linda.
Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
175 for the champ. Nothing so far for Joe. Joe, just relax into your seat, concentrate, and pick a star for me.
McLean.
Okay, McLean Stevenson. Was Joan Rivers the first woman to guest host The Tonight Show, or did Arlene Francis guest host the show back in 1962?
No question, Arlene Francis.
He says Arlene Francis did guest host that show in 1962. What do you say, Joe?
I agree.
Arlene did it in 1962. You were right to agree. You get the square, and you're on the board. And you know how quickly things can change. Try to keep the pressure on with another X if you can.
Gene, please.
Mr. Rayburn.
Yeah.
While driving through the Dutch countryside, you see a number of cows covered with blankets. Are they pregnant? Or are they used for transportation?
I have driven through the Dutch countryside, and I've never seen a cow covered with a blanket. So I'm going to have to take a wild shot at this and guess, which is really not the object of the game. You're supposed to know or give a good bluff. And I can't do either at this point. I would say, now let's see. You know Barbara Woodhouse.
Are we going to have time for the soap opera that comes on after this?
Barbara Woodhouse puts a saddle on a cow and jumps them over fences. So cows could be used as beasts of burden, even though we know them as milk givers. So I'd say yes, a cow could be used as a means of transportation.
He says the cows covered with blankets are used for transportation. Agree or disagree, Nancy?
I'll disagree.
The cows in the Dutch countryside covered with blankets are pregnant. You are right to disagree, and you get the square. Yeah, that makes somewhat more sense. Pia Zadora, I believe, is covered with a blanket. Joe, pick a star for an O.
Jamie, please.
All right, Mr. Farr.
All right, yes. It's Mr. Credit, Mr. Bauman.
You're a woman.
Again? Again with the woman?
Sound more familiar by the minute. You're a woman and you just enlisted in the U.S. Army.
Again?
Are you allowed to fraternize with the male enlistees? Or are they strictly off limits until you're through with basic training?
Having served as both, I would think that you could fraternize with them because you have to go through the same basic training that they go through. You have to go through the same bivouac and all the other things. So I think you could fraternize with them now.
He says you're allowed to fraternize with the male enlistees. If you're a woman, agree or disagree, Joe?
I agree.
You are allowed to fraternize with the male enlistees, and you are right to agree. You get the square and have taken a bit of command in this game. Nancy, pick a star.
Heidi to block, please.
Otherwise, if you miss this one, the game and the lead goes to Joe Credit.
Your friend from England called you at 3 a.m. to tell you he'd burst his geyser. Was he talking about his appendix or his water heater?
His appendix.
To block, agree or disagree, that geyser is his appendix, Nancy.
I'll agree.
If he burst his geyser, he'd burst his water heater. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets a square, and your opponent wins the game. Joe Credit, you have done it. You've come back from a lot of ribbing, and you have taken the lead. All right, we are going to clear the board immediately, zip right on to the next game, which is worth $300. We're going to start it with our champ, Nancy.
McLean, please.
After months of research, two chemists from the University of Minnesota finally came up with a new compound. Is it synthetic garlic or wet air?
It is synthetic garlic.
What do you say, Nancy?
I'll agree.
It is synthetic garlic. You were right to agree, and you get the first square in the $300. Wet air? What is wet air? We'll be back to find out. Well, I'm sure we'll never find that out, but we'll find out what happens to the $300 game after this. $225 for the champ. A close one going. It's a $300 game. Obviously, everything rides on this. Joe Credit, your move for an O.
Paula?
Paula Kelly. You're a hungry, praying mantis ready to attack a fly. At the last minute, you realize it's dead. Will you still eat it, or does it have to be alive and kicking?
My instinct says it has to be alive and kicking.
What do you say, Joe? Agree or disagree?
I agree.
You will eat the dead fly. You should have disagreed with Paula, and your opponent gets that square.
I'm sure you were right.
Right.
Oh.
So, Nancy, you got a couple of X's up there. Make your move.
Arsenio to win, please.
This would give you the lead back.
You guys are going to blow up for Joe. Go on.
You are.
Arsenio, we all know that Ronald Reagan's daughter, Patty, is an actress.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's quite okay. We all know that Ronald Reagan's daughter, Patty, is an actress. But the child of another presidential candidate is also trying to make it big in show business. Is it Walter Mondale's daughter or Jesse Jackson's son?
Wow. I'm almost positive it's Mondale's daughter.
What do you say for the game? Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
It is Walter Mondale's daughter. You are right to agree. You get the square and you win the game. Walter Mondale's daughter is going to be in show business. Nancy Lazarus has taken the lead, but there are three X's on the board, which we are now going to remove. We're going to clear the board and zip right along to the $400 game, and anything can happen. Joe, pick a star.
McLean, please.
McLean Stevenson. This is not a safe lead by any means, as you know. Minnie Mouse's guests never showed for dinner, McLean. Can Minnie freeze her cheese balls? Or will they be permanently damaged?
You'll not get a zany answer from me on this one, big guy. You can't freeze your cheese balls. So our cheese balls are going to be bad. Green, fuzzy, bad.
He says the cheese balls will be permanently damaged.
That's
what do you
right.
say, Joe?
I agree.
Minnie Mouse can freeze her cheese balls. You should have disagreed with McLean.
Never ate it.
And your opponent gets that square, but Minnie is greatly relieved. Nancy, pick a star for an X.
Chuck, please.
All right, Chuck Woolery into the fray.
Thank you.
The way things are going, you get applause because you haven't done anything yet.
Just wait, John.
You're the only innocent person up there, Chuck. When a man sees an ad with a nude woman in it, is he likely to remember the product, or does he usually forget what the ad was about?
You know, they usually tell us when we're going for commercials that they don't like handsome people and they don't like nude women because it usually draws the attention to the person instead of the product. I would say the product. I'm guessing, but I would say the product.
Wait.
Oh, well, pardon me. They would not remember the product.
Right.
They would remember the
girl. They usually
forget
what the ad was about. Agree or disagree, Nancy?
I'll agree.
They usually do forget. The man does forget when the ad has a nude woman in it. I'll buy that. Whatever it was. You got the square. Joe,
Gene,
your move.
Gene for the block, please.
Now, this is absolutely critical at this point in the game because if Nancy wins it, she's got a humongous lead. What is America's longest-running musical, Gene? Is it Grease or The Fantastics?
Fantastics has been going for about 26 years. I think it's Fantastics.
He says The Fantastics is America's longest-running musical. What do you say, Joe?
I'll agree.
Right to agree. It is The Fantastics. You get the score. You do one. Very important for you. And it's 25 years. Very close for Gene. Only 8 years for Grease. Nancy, your move.
I'll go with Paula, please.
Paula Kelly. You're a typical lighthouse. Are you manned or unmanned?
I'm manned.
Says a typical lighthouse is manned. What do you say, Nancy?
I think I'll disagree.
That is why you have been the champ for 3 days, because a typical lighthouse is unmanned. You are right to disagree, and you get the square. And had you missed that one, that would have put Joe in a very strong position. Hard to disagree at the right time. You have done it well. Time is up. She has done it. Fourth day in a row, Nancy Lazarus is our champ. $650. Good for you. Zoom your way over there. Join Gene. Get set once again for your shot at the big money. Congratulations to you, Joe Credit. Your total leaving here is $300. And of course, thanks for playing Magic Game Hollywood Squares. Good for you. You're a good guy. Joe Credit
now. And we'll return with her in the nine stars right after these messages.
To play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Gene Wood, thank you. Nancy, third day. You're familiar with this routine, and once again, you're going to try for the big dough. Let's go and see if you get it. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Chicken blank. Remember, if you give us the answer they wrote down most often, we give you $1,000. For the next one, $500, and for the third, $250. Any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance here by suggesting answers. Whom do you call on first?
John?
Yeah, you know, I'll just go with the first thing that popped into my head. There are a few good ones, unfortunately. I'll say Chicken Little.
There's one.
Okay, Arsenio?
Let's go with something old-fashioned like chicken soup.
Chicken soup. Yeah.
Chuck?
Chicken pot pie.
Chicken pot pie. All right, so there you have it. Chicken pot pie, chicken soup, and chicken little. You want one of those or one of your own?
Chicken soup.
Chicken soup is what she's after.
Chicken little.
Good old chicken soup. It's very healthy stuff, you know. It's not just an old wives' tale. It really is good for you. Let's see if chicken soup is under the $250 response. Chicken pox is there.
Oh,
a pox on your chicken.
Oh, sure.
All right. Let's see what we got under the $500 response. Chicken Little. All right. There's John's answer.
Chicken soup's
got
to be it.
Now, here's your last chance for chicken soup. Go! Yeah! $100,000. Wow.
Okay.
You're almost up to
$25,000. Good.
Now for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing, and after you've made your decision, we'll ask the star to reveal the hidden number. And we hope this time you get a 30, because that means you'll be playing for $30,000. Where do you think the 30 is?
Pick McLean.
No. I'll try John.
You think John might have the 30?
Okay.
Ready? Go. 10. 10,000 is what you're playing for.
What a horrible disappointment. Only $10,000.
A goodly sum, Nancy.
Not too badly.
Right. Good luck to you. Here it is. Blank candy. C-A-N-D-Y. Blank candy. John's ready, Nancy. You collect the $10,000 simply by matching him. What do you say to that?
Chocolate candy.
Chocolate candy. All right, John, she says chocolate candy will match you. What do you say?
I went with the first thing that popped into my head again this
what?
Time. And last time was Chicken Little, and this time it was cotton candy.
Cotton candy. Cotton candy. Well, you haven't done too badly. You won a pretty good bundle of money on the Hollywood Squares part, and you got the $1,000 here, so that means you have $24,000. No, I think you got a little more than $24,000. Did you add up her Hollywood Squares part of it also? Is that the correct total? All right, $24,000 isn't bad. We'll be back with the champ here and the stars right after this.
Like to be a member of our studio audience here on The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to tickets. The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, 3000 West Alameda Avenue, Burbank, California, 91523.
Here we go. Now we're going to have the big reveal. Find out which of the stars had the 130 that's up there. Ready, set, go. Arlene had big number.
So
well, Arlene and gang, you were splendid. We hope to get all of you back together in this same wonderful, zany combination. Okay?
Oh, really? Are you
yeah.
sure?
Yeah. We'd love to have you back. You want to set a date?
They were a funny crew.
All right.
And probably they still are.
Now, you're going to have a weekend off.
That's right.
And we'll see you here on Monday.
I'll be here.
Okay. I'll be here, too. I'm Gene Rayburn, inviting you to be here on Monday.
John Valvin saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
A member of our studio audience will receive Tappan's deluxe microwave oven with Tappan Touch controls, built-in browner, 10 different cooking speeds so you can program to defrost and cook automatically, furnished by Tappan. And some of our departing contestants will receive Near East Offer's Old World Flavor, an alternative to popular potatoes. Discover Near East Rice Pilaf, the original 100% natural from Near East Foods. Clean and clear, leaves no dulling residue. It's the no-rinse cleaner for a clearly beautiful floor. Boratine, the Borax Bleacher, was formulated for the big switch to warm water washing. Now for whiter, brighter, more stain-free wash, switch to Boratine, the Borax Bleacher. Niagara, America's number one selling spray starch. It helps prevent the deep penetration of soil and stains. You get a crisper, firmer finish with Niagara Spray Starch. Only Q-Tex Remover has moisture guard to protect nails against drying and breaking. No wonder it's America's number one remover. Speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.
Call it a traveling news program. Call it a news program where politicians get to question those who report about them. Call it a program that tells you what happened this week. Call it live television. Call it Summer Sunday USA. Join Linda Ellaby and Andrea Mitchell on the news program for smart people. Summer Sunday, live except on the West Coast.